Now I'd like to bring up our Chief Operating Officer, Steve Wilhite, who will tell you a little bit about where we're going. Everybody hear me okay? Terrific. It's been 6 months since I joined the company. For those of you that don't know me, Steve Wilhite came most recently from Tokyo. And still every day I wake up and feel like, oh, thank God I'm waking up in the United States. During that 6 months, it's been a pretty busy time for the company and for me. I've traveled extensively, meeting with our Korean colleagues in Seoul on a number of occasions. I've traveled throughout the United States, meeting with dealers and our people. I've tried to listen very intently, and I think I've learned a great deal about our opportunities, about our culture, and about what we can accomplish with this company. I've met great people pretty much wherever I've traveled, people who are energized about our business and enthused about the opportunity, and people who have very strongly held opinions about what we ought to be doing and how we ought to be growing our business. It seems that there are really kind of three big issues that we've identified and that we're working on very aggressively. The first is dealer profitability and market representation. You know, it doesn't matter if we continue to bring really terrific products to market, if we do everything right from a marketing communication perspective. At the end of the day, if customers wind up going into our dealerships and having a bad experience, it's all for naught. So we've got a big opportunity and challenge to continue to improve the quality of our representation and improve the profitability of our dealers. A second big task is to improve the operational excellence and performance of our business. There are clearly ways for us, as there are for most car makers, to improve efficiencies, take unnecessary costs out of the system, and improve our profitability. As you all know, the industry has been under attack, and lack of profitability has been a consistent problem for most manufacturers in the industry. And the third, and maybe most important, is to build our brand. We have incredible stories to tell, but unfortunately, most people really don't know about those stories. If we were to go outside in front of the lodge and stop people, let's say we stopped 100 people, how many do you think would be able to name all of the products that we currently sell in the United States? One, two, five? Certainly some number far less than 100. That's a big loss and big opportunity for us. And if we were to talk to people about what our brand stands for, what do you think they'd tell us? Oh, come on. Basically two things: inexpensive cars and long warranty. Well, those are maybe fair characteristics, but they're pretty limited. In fact, we've got a much more robust story to tell from a product perspective, a business perspective, and many of the characteristics of our brand and of our products. So what we've really done to tackle these is pretty simple. We've moved very quickly. Chris is fond of using the term at Hyundai speed. We have moved very quickly to address these things. First, we've restructured our dealer pricing and incentive programs to give dealers a clear idea of where they stand and what they have to work with. Two, we've developed a very specific market representation plan. It started at the bottom up from our district managers and is very clearly defined in every district by every dealer. Every dealer this year has a clear understanding of what their objectives are and what we expect from them. That's a first. We've developed teams, cross-functional teams, to address some of the operational issues facing our business. And we've strengthened our executive team pretty dramatically. I'm fortunate when I got here to find really a very talented group of senior executives, but we've made the team even stronger with the recent additions of Joel Iwanek, who is our new VP of Marketing, and Dave Zukowski, who is our new VP of Sales. We've also reorganized and restructured our marketing department to align more intelligently with some of the tasks that we have. And finally, we've initiated a search for a new agency. That's a lot to accomplish in 6 months. Somebody once likened this to trying to change a flat tire, moving it about 80 miles an hour. It certainly isn't easy, but for us, there's no alternative. We need to move very quickly to take advantage of the opportunities we have. And obviously, we're a very ambitious company with pretty aggressive goals. So that's kind of a quick overview of where we are. We've got lots of news to share. In addition to Veracruz today, I thought I'd do perhaps two things. First, in our search for a new agency, we've done a lot of soul searching to figure out how to tell our stories more honestly and in a more compelling way. So I thought I'd share a few pieces of video with you. These are commercial videos that will wind up finding their way into the public a little later this month and early in May. So if we could take a second and roll these pieces, please.
Smart. Who in the world doesn't want to be smart? The whole human race wants to be smart. Even guys who aren't smart wish they were smart. Being called smart is the highest compliment you can be paid. And while some things are cool for a moment in time, smart has never gone out of style. Smart people are whom we've always counted on and admired the most. When stranded on a desert island, whom did everyone turn to? The smart guy. Even in athletics, the smart guys always come out on top. To be smart, you don't need to be rich and successful, but if you are rich and successful, you're probably pretty darn smart. One thing you'll consistently find in smart people is they make smart choices. That's because smart people do their homework, which allows them to make educated, smart decisions. Now, when it comes to buying a car, there's nothing smarter than buying a Hyundai. Hyundai has America's best warranty. It's very smart. And do you know who has the highest rated minivan ever tested by the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety? That's right, Hyundai. And do you know whose SUV was named 2007 SUV of the Year by Auto Vitel? Whose sedan was named Editor's Most Wanted Sedan for under $30,000 by Edmunds.com? Who earned two Strategic Vision Awards for Best Total Value? And who won the Best in Class Sedan for under $20,000 by Kiplinger's Personal Finance? You guessed it. Hyundai, 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 and Hyundai. So when you think about everything, when you think about quality and warranty and awards, when you think about safety and features and value for your hard-earned money, it's all clear that choosing Hyundai is the smartest way to go. Hyundai. Smart move. We took the Land Rover LR3 and compared it to the Hyundai Santa Fe. The Santa Fe beat the Land Rover in the 0-60 test and in the quarter-mile test. It also beat the Land Rover on the dry slalom and the wet slalom course, as well as in dry and wet accident avoidance tests. But the Land Rover did beat the Santa Fe in number of cup holders. Well, you can't win everything. The Hyundai Santa Fe, $13,000 less than the Land Rover, and a few less cup holders. Hyundai, smart move. The Hyundai Sonata Limited has 19 more horsepower than the BMW 525i. It also has superior acceleration, a larger cabin, the same number of airbags, a premium stereo, leather-trimmed seats, and America's best warranty. But the Sonata costs $20,000 less than the BMW. We just thought you might like to know. The Hyundai Sonata. Smart move. The Hyundai Azera Limited has a luxurious leather-trimmed interior. So does the Lexus LS460. The Azera has a premium 10-speaker 6-CD audio system. The Lexus does too. The Azera has dual-zone automatic climate control. The Lexus does as well. However, the Lexus can parallel park itself. And the Azera can't. But at half the price, you can easily afford to have someone park the Azera for you. The Hyundai Azera. Smart move.
I'm not sure, but I think that's the first time I've gotten a laugh or applause for a commercial from a group of journalists in my life. That's certainly indicative of the direction that we're going. And we think that it adequately captures our brand, our values, and the tonality that we want to express in the marketplace. One last thing I'd like to share with you, a little bit of a taste for what we've got coming next week. We could go to the next slide, the new Concept Genesis, which we'll proudly unveil in New York next week. Hopefully most of you folks will be there, and maybe to tell you a few things more about this and to